Hey, what's up guys? My name is Prestige. Welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how to put any camouflage you want on any weapon you want in Call of Duty Black Ops 3. You can also put black market camouflages on black market weapons, get some awesome camouflage combinations that you can't normally have in the game. And the only reason I'm showing you guys this is because I feel like it's a harmless little glitch. Treyarch already knows about it. It's going to be patched soon, so I figured go ahead, try it out for yourself. It's a lot of fun, and I just wish that they would let us use black market camouflages on the black market weapons. So this is actually shown to me by ayyreza. I'll go ahead and put his Twitter account down below in the description. Go on over there, let him know that Prestige sent you, but let's get started. So first things first, we'll go into the creator class in public match and I'll show you that the Banshee, for example, doesn't have the black market selection for camouflages, and the Marshall 16 is the same way. It doesn't have the black market selection, and it also doesn't have a zombie selection. So any camouflage that you have unlocked for a specific weapon, you can actually have on any of these DLC weapons. It's a little more technical than before, so let me go through step by step. Now, first things first, you're going to want to go into the Gunsmith. This is easiest done if you don't have any variants as is. So if you don't have any Gunsmith variants like I don't here, you can easily do this. It will take you 2 seconds to create a camo. So first thing you need to do, go to the Gunsmith and go to the weapon that has the camouflage you want to use. So for example, I'm going to create a variant of the CUDA because I know this weapon has a black market camouflage that I want to use, which is Jungle Party. Jungle Party's nice. This works for the newer camouflages as well, but I noticed that if you try to use Haptic, it doesn't work. Energon works, but some of them can be a little glitchy. So I'm going to select Jungle Party because it's one of my favorite camouflages in Black Ops 3. We'll save that variant, and we'll see that the CUDA has that variant on it right now. Step number two is to create the variants of the weapon that cannot have this camouflage. So the Banshee cannot have this camouflage. What we're going to do is create 2 variants. We don't need to put any camouflage on it. We're just going to create 2 dummy variants. So now we have 2 variants with nothing on it. And now we're going to do the glitch. So go back to your CUDA or whatever weapon you originally had and scroll over to Jungle Party. Do not select it. From this, you want to press Start, go down to Media Manager, and you'll see our variants that we've created just now. So we have the first Banshee variant, and then we have the second Banshee variant. Now what you're gonna wanna do is delete the very first variant by pressing X or A, depending on what console you're on. Go ahead and delete the variant. You'll see that now it went away, and we're currently hovering over the second Banshee variant. Now from here, do not press up, do not press down, just back out. You could see now, we have the variant of the Banshee in the CUDA spot, which is kind of weird. So go ahead and press X to select. Go ahead and reapply your camouflage. In this instance, we were using Jungle Party. We'll go ahead and back out of here and save. Now you can see our CUDA has the Jungle Party, but if we head on over to our shotguns, you will also see that our Banshee has the Jungle Party. Now, just for another example, I will go ahead and delete these variants and run through the process one more time. And now that I'm thinking about it, I don't necessarily think you need to have the variant with the camouflage on it. I would just go ahead and do that for safety measure. We'll go ahead and do the Pharaoh because I know I have transgression on the Pharaoh and I like that camouflage. So we'll go ahead and put transgression on it. Transgression looks really nice. Save that variant. And we will go to our buzz cut. The buzz cut's one of the new melee weapons. We'll go ahead and put our GGs again. We'll create 2 variants. GG, done. Confirm. There we go. Save. So we have 2 variants now. Head back to our SMG. Go ahead and press Media Manager. We'll see that we have the 2 buzz cut variants. Now delete the first one, the very first one. It will be hovering over our buzz cut. We're going to back out of here. We'll see the buzz cut is in the variant slot. Press X to select it. Go over to camouflage again. Black market, transgression. Back out of there. Save the variant. Head on over to our secondaries. And if everything was done right, we should see transgression right there. Boom, baby. Right on the buzz cut weapon, which looks really, really nice. And once again, I know a lot of people liked this because you were able to do it with zombie camouflages, with the Red Hex camo, which was really, really nice. So I will do an example of that really quick too, so you guys can see the process one more time. I know this video is a little bit longer, but it is a little confusing. So let's go ahead and go to the KN44, create our variant. This weapon has the Red Hex camouflage that we spoke about. So we have Red Hex. We'll go ahead and save that. We will head over to the Banshee once again, because I really, really like the Banshee. I've been having fun with it lately. We'll make two variants of the Banshee. Once those two variants are made, they don't need to have camouflages. Head back over to the KN44. Do not select this. Press start, media manager, delete the very first one, then back out. You'll see the Banshee's now in the selection list. Head on in there, go over to camo, select Red Hex or whatever else you want to select. Back out, it will save there, and it will also save right there on the Banshee. So that is how you do it, guys. This also works if you want to actually use these things in game, so you can go ahead and select them like that. This is not going to make any difference whatsoever with the game itself. It's literally just giving your weapon a different aesthetic look. Treyarch already knows about this. They're going to be patching it soon, just like they patched the Red Hex camouflage before. But this is pretty fun. I just want to let you guys know, try it out for yourself. It's really easy to do, and it works for any other weapon out there as well. So if you have Dark Matter, for example, and you just got one of the new DLC weapons, you can do the same exact thing with the Dark Matter camouflage on the DLC weapon without actually doing any of the challenges, which is really nice. So let me know what you guys think down below in the comment section. If you enjoyed this video here today, make sure to click the like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And until next time, guys, I am out. Peace.